of the mountain goats. This is a song about you and the one you love and a hotel room in Florida. It's called the Off-Ounce Mambo. Now keep it loud for me, please. I can almost hear the rhythm section kick in as the drums began to play. I saw you walk across the plaza. Sick again. I think it's gonna happen real soon. And I know I can't afford another night here in this place with a 16th floor view of the ocean and the dunes. It's gonna be just you and me today. Waiting for the other shoe to drop in Tampa Bay. Gambit. It's a song about coming home after a manner of speaking. I was having visions of sugared pastry cooked up in clarified butter. I tried to turn my visions into prayer. I built my castles way high up in the air, and I came to the gates of the fabled pink city, hungry and tired and cold. Swing low, sweet cherry, chrome tailpipe shining bright as spun gold. My brothers picked me up out of the rushes, traded me into the company of evil men, but I have inched my way down the eastern seaboard. I am coming to Atlanta again. Yeah, I came to the gates of the fabled pink city, hungry and tired, mad as all hell. Swing low, sweet jewel-encrusted chariot. Make me young again, make me well. I am the landmine hidden in the sand, and I came to the gates of the fabled pink city, hungry and tired and alone. You swing low, sweet, 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 sweet chariot, coming for to carry me home. Thank you. Thank you so much. Okay, look, I know when people say this, you must go, oh yeah, you say that in New York and Boston and Berlin or wherever, but I really love this town. This is an amazing city. So, right on. This is a song that takes place in Texas. It's called Source Decay. Drive 2 hours east to check the Austin post office box, and I take the detour through our old neighborhood, see all the Chevy Impalas in their front yards up on blocks, and I park in an alley where I pick through the postcards you continue to send. As indirectly as you can, you ask what I remember. I like these torture devices from my old best friend. Well, I'll tell you what I know, like I swore I always would. I don't think it's gonna do you any good. I remember the train headed south out of Bangkok down to warm the water. Get a late start when the sun's going down and the traffic's thinning out and the air is hard to take, and I wish the West Texas Highway was a Mobius strip. I could ride it out forever. When I hear my heart break, you know, I swear I feel it happen. It's that clean and that hard. I come in off the highway and I park in my front yard. Fall out of the car like a hostage from a plane. Think of you a while, start wishing it would rain. And I remember the train headed south out of Bangkok down to warm the water. Postcard on the table with all the others like it. I start picking through the pile. I check the pictures and the address and the captions and the stamps for signs of any pattern at all. When I come up empty-handed, the feeling almost overwhelms me. I let a few of my defenses fall and I smile a brittle smile. It's not a pretty sight to see. I think about a railroad platform back in 1983 and I remember the train headed south of Bangkok down towards the water. Merci. Very funny. This is the first love song I ever wrote for my wife before I had ever laid eyes on her face. It's named after her post office box in Grinnell, Iowa, where we used to exchange letters before we knew what one another looked like. It's called 02-75. At every word you said, and you are my best friend, and I have always known you.
all right if I play a couple of quieter songs? This is on a 7-inch, on a split 7-inch with John Vanderslice, which is already sold out, and I don't have any copies to sell to you, so I'm sorry about that. Anyway, it's a love song, after a manner of speaking. It's called, well, here's the thing. The U.S. military has this way of coming up with nice ways of describing bad things. So you have hard targets. That's buildings and military installations and streets, right? And then you have soft targets, and that's people, right? This song is called Soft Targets. Start breaking plates, and I'll do what I can to stay out of your way. There is nobody innocent here. I got more blood on my hands than you do. It's you and it's me, and the baby makes three. Yeah, but we've got our love to carry us through. We've got our love to carry us through. Future's awake in the attic. He moans and he wails as he rattles his chain. We embrace on the floor in the kitchen, emissaries from neighboring lands. When I hunt down the vampire that did this to us, I will rip out his heart with my hands. I will rip out his heart with my hands. Promises with this next song because I didn't practice it, but my friend Jen, who's from Korea, it happens to be here, and so I thought I would try something that's called Downtown Seoul from the Sweden album. Thank you. If it doesn't work though, you gotta blame Jen. She's right over there. Young. hand on my face. Took your index finger in between my teeth and I held it gently in place. It was resting lightly on my tongue in there. I saw you shaking in the cold Korean air, and there, but for the grace of the Lord of Song, I would be this very second, and you're coming right along. You had your cardigan on. I looked upon the sky, but the white curve was gone. I remember your eyelids. I remember your body now. Okay, well, I don't get over here very often, so if there's anything you want to hear, you should say so now. What?
Seeing daylight.
I don't know if I can play that one. No, I can't. I'm sorry, I don't know. What was that? I can try. Kimya, are you around?
Thank you.
Could you supply me with a capo or a capo or however you pronounce that? Hold on, I'm going to try No Children. Thanks. I never play this song live though, so if it like totally, if I fuck it up completely, it's that guy's fault.
Thanks, man.
Okay, I think I put it here. I never play this song live, but it's a love song. It's about how when two people love one another, but then they succumb to the urge to want to kill each other, what's love like then? You remaining friends give up on trying to save us. I hope we come up with a fail-safe plot to piss off the dumb few that forgave us. I hope the fences we mended fall down beneath their own weight, and I hope we hang on past the last exit. I hope it's already too late, and I hope the junkyard a few blocks from here someday burns down. Myself shaving tomorrow, I hope it bleeds all day long. Our friends say it's darkest before the sun rises. We're pretty sure they're all wrong. I hope it stays dark forever. I hope the worst isn't over. Yeah, and I hope you blink before I do. I hope I never get sober. And I hope when you think of me years down the line, you can't find one good thing to say. And I'd hope that if I found the strength to walk out, you'd stay the hell out of my way. I am drowning. There is no sign of land. You are coming down with me. And in unlovable hand, I hope you die. I hope you die. That was really exciting for me. I never play that song live. That was really cool. This song was on a record called Tallahassee. Thanks. And it's another love song, sort of. Well, guy in a skeleton costume comes up to the guy in the Superman suit, runs through him with a broadsword. I took the television off. Came back today. What's that? No, come closer, I can hear you. Well, the unfortunate thing for those of you in the back is I can hear people in the front better. This is a song, and it's, well, of course it's a song, because it'd be weird if I was about to do a play, but this is a song about how there's a moment in every relationship where you look at the person you love, and you think inside yourself, well, I don't actually love you anymore. What am I going to do now? I don't want to say that, you know. I mean, what would happen if I said that? Well, nothing would happen. Right, I mean, you just have a conversation, but you think inside yourself something disastrous will happen, so you don't say nothing. Then it's next week, right, and you still feel the same way. Now what are you going to do? Now you've spent a week living a terrible lie. So, well, you've already got a week invested, you might as well give it another year. That's what this song is about. It's called The Recognition Scene.
Around you, and I let my
my face sank down into your hair. Inhaled as deeply as I possibly could. Well, you were sweet and delicious as the warm desert air. And you pointed your headlamp toward the horizon. We were the two things in the galaxy God didn't have his eyes on. 900 cc's of raw whining power. No outstanding warrants for my arrest. I did a little DD. If anybody wanted to send me up another beer, I wouldn't complain.
Yeah, drink your beer!
Anyone here?
Yes, inside.
I can't play it, I'm sorry. Yeah, I can do it.
This gentleman here wants to hear a song that's never been released. It's called You're in Maya. It's one of the very few true stories in my arsenal, and I feel really weird playing it. Without him, I wouldn't be here. So give it up for Benoit. And he's easy on the eyes, besides.
All right, what's next?
Nico, don't look at your set list, man.
I gotta look at the set list, man. I believe in the set list. I'm a strong believer in the set list. I think you will be too when I get done with this next song. This is a song about alcohol. And the wondrous things that can, you know, the ways that can bring a relationship to a place that it mightn't have gone before. Right? A bad place, but a place that it mightn't have gone before. It was on an album called Sweden, and it's called Clonifirox. Change things up a little bit. Is it okay if I play a new one?
Yeah, let's see America, all right.
This is off the album I just finished recording with John Vanderslice, who you gotta hear. It's the best record I've ever made. I'm not gonna go on about it, but it really is better than anything I've ever done. It's about all my old friends up in Portland. May most of them rest in peace. It's called Pankora Yajna.
Ocean, Florida.
captured what I needed. Using shiny new machines and the headstones climbed up the hills. Thanks. Where's my friend Lisa? Thank you so much. I don't know if you saw her band the other night at the Green Eyed Pirate, but they're awesome. I have to find the lyrics. We just wrote this song this week. I should better put my glasses on for this. Hold on one moment. So yeah, this is a brand new song. I wrote it day before yesterday. It's called Scavenger Babies. From the clay, seal the exits of your room, watch the cactus flowers bloom,
and send my regards to the boys down on the corner.
Yeah,
send my regards to the boys down on the corner.
Poison singing in your blood. Fill yourself a call to ring. Carve your initials in the bathroom sink.
And send my regards to the boys down on the corner.
Supposed to save
and send my belongings to the drop box in Tijuana. And send my regards to the boys out on the corner. Hey.
Mr. Daniel Proto, where are you? I would like at this point to welcome to the stage the bassist for the best band in the universe, Refrigerator, Mr. Daniel Proto. We have never played live together before as a duo, so if this goes badly, I want you to consider the last song as the end of the set. This is all like bonus tracks, right?
Bonus tracks!
Bonus tracks! Y'all know what time it is? This is a song about a man. What they found at the bottom of a swamp in Denmark. And he, you know what I'm talking about. He had been there for like 4,000 years. And because scientists are very clever, they were able to tell what the last thing he ate was before he died. He died because he was the local candidate for a sacrifice. How he garnered that honor is unknown, but it's suspected that it was random. So it's as though somebody came to your house one day and said, "We're gonna drown you, get ready." I was sitting at the edge of the marsh when the council came to bring me the news. They handed me a bowl of cooked wild grasses and they gave me the ceremonial shoes. Get some rest. Well, no, wait, the wave targets, no, not wave, wave pictures are next. Stick around for that. It's awesome. After that, we can all get some rest.
Right.
This is a dance number. It's been great to see you. I will see you guys again about February. I'll be back. I have a new record coming out and all that. Right. We'll talk about that then. This is a song. It's about people. They go down to Florida. It doesn't go well for them. Right.
What?
Yeah, they wish it would go well for them, but it's rather too late for them to turn back. So what can you do? Watch them burn. It's called See America Right. Good night. I was driving up from Tampa when the radiator burst. I was 3 sheets to the wind. A civilian saw me first, and then there was a cop, and then the children standing on a corner. About to drop when they got because I missed and I feel bad about it. So.
The river song.
No, man, that's a terrible encore.
I'm going.
Now.
What a song. Thank you.
Keep guessing.
There will be no divorce. Going back to Georgia.
What was that?
There will be no divorce.
Going to Georgia.
That's what I'm talking about. Somebody take care of that for me for a minute. Right. Again. It's the most extraordinary feeling in the whole world. I have two big hands and a heart pumping blood and a 1967 Colt 45 with a busted safety catch. Yeah. The world shines. See you in the spring.